parlay. Who that nigga parlay? He's a ghetto star. He's a ghetto star. He's a ghetto star. He's a ghetto star. They say who that nigga parlay? Who that nigga parlay? Who that nigga parlay? Who that nigga parlay? He's a ghetto star. He's a ghetto star. He's a ghetto star. He's a ghetto star.
Bitch, I'm a celebrity.
Shit, what's poppin'? What's poppin'? We back, man. Here to the streets. Parlay Starr, man. My special guest today is my boy E.D.I. Mean I. E.D.I. Don. What's up with you, my nigga?
What's happening, man? You already know. Oh, man. Glad to be here, man. Thanks for having me.
Shit, no, I appreciate you. Thanks for coming, man. You know what I mean? Yeah. You've been any place in the motherfucking world, but he's fucking with his boy today.
You already know.
And that's what we doing. What's been up with you, man?
Just working, man. Just working, man. You know what I mean? Living and man, your new enjoying life.
Yeah, man, your new album, man. Let me grab it right here, man. My nigga, new album right here. You can check it out right here.
Established 1992, hosted by Mike Epps. 15 classic bangers on there.
Man, I
played straight through from the bottom. A lot of niggas say that, but you can really play that from top to bottom and not skip nothing.
Absolutely.
I'm putting my reputation on that. You know what I mean?
So I'm putting mine too.
You already know. So you know that's G shit right there. You can pick it up online everywhere. You know what I mean? If you see me in traffic, I'll slide you a hard copy.
I mean, like that right there. For y'all that don't know this, E.D.I. Mean, he's with the Outlawz. You know, he used to rap with Tupac back in the day. One of Tupac disciples, you know what I mean? The last of that real shit, you know what I mean? Cut from that cloth, you know what I mean? And I just want to ask you a couple of questions about the rap game. I mean, how do you feel about the change of the rap game? Is you with it, or how you feel about it, man?
I mean, I ain't got no choice to be with it, you know what I mean? Because you either adapt or you die. You know what I'm saying? So I'm all the way with it, and it's a lot of it I appreciate, you know what I mean, that I can get into, and it's some of it that I don't like, and whatever I don't like, I don't listen to.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? But me being in the game, you know, 20 years, you know, I love the fact that it's more opportunity and it's more ways for you to get your music to the world with the aid of the internet. You know, I love that side of it, but then again, the internet creating these overnight stars too that ain't really put their work in and don't really take it as serious as, you know, some of us, quote unquote, OGs do. So, you know, it's the good and the bad. It's the give and the take. Feel me?
Yeah, man, the niggas done put their work in, man. They got niggas like Trinidad James is getting deals off some bullshit, man. Y'all need to stop letting these fuckboys get famous. Fuckboys don't need to be famous, man. That's what's fucking the rap game up right now. You know what I mean?
Mm-hmm. Okay.
But I want to ask you, though, man, how was it like with Pac, man? Because you and a couple of more Outlawz, man, y'all experienced and shared some. That's incredible, man. You know, Pac was like a Malcolm X and Martin Luther King to me, personally. You know what I mean?
To you and a lot of other people.
Yeah, I didn't look at him as no rapper. Mm-hmm. I didn't look at him as no, no. That nigga was like Malcolm X and Martin Luther King. Real shit. You know what I mean? And if you listen to his music now, if he had 10 million motherfuckers following him with the shit he was rapping, this world would be different. Niggas really wouldn't be taking shit from the police. All kind of crazy shit. You agree with me?
Yeah, yeah. I feel as though his music is still influential to this day. And he got, you know, 10, 20. You know, the number is limitless. Like I said, we just got back from Mexico City, Mexico. And the crowd was predominantly full of kids, you know, from 19 to 25. And they singing, you know, the old records like it just came out. They know them word for word. Some of them don't even speak English. Yeah. So, you know, music is a universal language. And Pac's music was definitely able to touch people no matter what race, color, creed, nationality, or language they were speaking, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
Or financial position they was in too. You know, he spoke for the people that was poor, you know, he spoke for the people that was, you know, doing well. So he was that rare artist that can reach all people on all levels.
Yeah, you know, I was Pac, I mean, that you
was a real energetic dude, man, and who was very confident. And had a strong belief in himself and what he was here to do.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? He was clear about his mission from an early age, you know what I mean? So that's why, you know, he had that confidence, and some might call it bravado. But he was just like one of the homies that we grow up with and that, you know, just happened to be super talented and happened to make it and then say, I'm gonna bring all my homeboys with me and all my family members with me and, you know, get them this rap money too.
We back. Ear to the streets, man. What's pop locking with y'all, man? Happy New Year's. This is 2014. You know what I mean? I wish everybody blessings, success, money, health. You know what I mean? Let's have a positive year this year. You know what I mean? I don't want too much beef going on, especially with me. I just want everybody to love and let's win. If it's beef, it better be legitimate. And I want to see it all pan out right here on Ear to the Motherfucking Streets. But we back. This is Parlay News, man. And the first, let me get comfortable. The first thing we got going on right now is my boy 50 Cent. 50 Cent is talking about getting back with Young Buck, and it's a possibility that G-Unit can be dropping another album. And that shows growth with 50 Cent. It shows maturity. It shows that time do heal things. And he said that it might be a possibility that Pharrell might produce the whole album, which is another good business move by 50 Cent. 50 Cent is smart business, man. I fucks with 50. We got Waka Flocka, man. You know what I mean? Sorry to hear about the loss, man. You know, his brother died. You know what I mean? They say it's probably from suicide or, you know, no telling what really it is, but I'm not here to say hi, died. I'm just here to say that, you know, we mourn for you. I got a song I did with you, Waka Flocka, and I just, you know, I feel fucked up. You know what I mean? I got a brother. You know what I mean? I got sisters. I got siblings. So any motherfucker, they got a heart to feel. You know what I mean? I feel for you. Hopefully that you can get over this, and it gives you new material to write. It gives you a whole new drive and a whole new, you know, outlook of life. And, you know, you just feed from it and, you know, Waka Flocka, man, my condolences to you, bro. You know what I mean? It's hip-hop news. Feel me? We got Kid Ink. Kid Ink just got dropped a new album and shit. It's hot. You know what I mean? It's just doing its thing. It's doing its numbers. It's like one of the hottest albums out right now. Kid Ink, do your thing. You know what I mean? We got Ice Cube. Ice Cube finna drop a new album. It's called Everything's Corrupt. And I can't wait to hear, because there's so many fake-ass rappers out here. It's about time some of us real niggas is coming back out. You know what I mean? And it's well overdue for Ice Cube. We got DJ Quik. He's dropping a new album, a new studio album, which don't have no date, release date or nothing, but it is confirmed that he's in the studio working on a new album. So that's a good look. 2014 is starting up with some real niggas coming in the game again, coming back. We got Mitchie Slick. He just dropped the album. He got a single with my boy Sean Deez that's, you know, rocking. You know, support hip hop, support underground music, support the real niggas, man, because we ain't going no motherfucking where. You know what I mean? What else we got on Parlay News, man? We got, you know what I mean? And I went on YouTube and I checked it out. I did my research on it, and it all started from pilots wanting to take their airplanes home and try to make airplanes more compact the way they can take them home and put them in a garage. And with that being said, they're like, wait a minute, we can, you know, this might be, we might be onto something, you know what I mean? And they came up with this car right here, and I watched the YouTube on how it goes up and how it flies and how it shuts down and how it got all that radioactivity shit that all them radio, I mean, all them airplanes and shit be having. It's crazy. They still got some adjustments to make, you know what I mean? But they say by 2015, 16, that they might have a motherfucking answer. So, hey, if you live long enough, you might be in a flying motherfucking car. For real. We got Benzes. Look at this Benz right here, man. They got Benzes. This nigga custom made this Benz to drive in the snow. That's dope. It made Parlay News. That's dope. You know what I mean? Shit. I'm in the snow right now in Bozeman, Montana. I love to push one of them 500s all through the motherfucking snow. Like, for real, wood grain, everything. I can hell roof the music up, all black on black tent. I can hell roof in the snow on them blades right there. I wonder what are those, some 22s, what the fuck do you call them? What's the inches on them motherfuckers, man? That's funny, but that's what it is, you know what I mean? And that's Parlay Starr Hip Hop News, man. Let's get to it, man. We write to it and we write off it. Hell yeah, man, but shit, like I was saying, man, one thing I don't like about the whole situation about the OutLawz and Tupac, and I'm a fan of y'all. Nigga, I grew up listening to your shit. I don't like the way after my nigga Pac died, you know what I mean, motherfuckers like just like abandoned the motherfucking real ones. You know, like your niggas scared. Pac had niggas so scared. You know what I mean? It's like when you got love, you got love. You supposed to show that love and be like, man, we gotta look out for us niggas, man.
I mean, I think that's the way Pop would have did it if the shoe was on the other foot, but you know how it is, man. You can't expect people to be, you know, like you are. And then also, one thing about us, we never expected nothing from nobody after Pop died, because we already knew what it was.
Yeah,
because the homie was already telling us, like, look, this is what it is, and this is who real, and this is who ain't. So don't expect nothing. Feel me? So we never expected nothing. You know what I mean? We just kept moving and did what we did. And whatever love we got, we appreciated it. And if we didn't, we kept it matching. And we still here to this day. You know what I mean? And a lot of people ain't. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah, hell yeah, a lot of people ain't.
What album? Did you shoot any video?
Yeah, I shot about 3 videos off of this mixtape so far. Really 4. The latest video was a record called Slow Down. You know what I'm saying? That we gonna watch right now, right here on my homeboy's show. He gonna have a premiere, and it features my little homeboy Actual from Atlanta, and my girl David Payne. And it's a dope record.
Check it out.
Grew up wishing for boss, living in better days. Misguided, decided to go at whatever pay. Caviar dreams, sipping Kool-Aid in the kitchen, watching mama fry some chicken. Roaches in there waiting with us. Probably wasn't never meant to make it, but I'm a klepto for my dreams. I see a way and I'ma take it. Here's a crash course on how to maintain. Just stay in your lane, don't ever let them lames make you change. If it ain't gon' make you change, then why do it? If it don't make dollars, it don't make sense. Pimpin', I thought you knew this. I took my share, bumps and bruises, still way ahead of the losers. This for the homies in them beach cruises, throwing up the deuces. Who is that? E.D.I, hotter than the sauna, with some Dolce and Gabbana shades on. Blowing potent marijuana, holler when you see him, but you better make it quick. I ain't good at small talk, my nigga.
Slow
I'm on that beat.
Slow
shit.
It down, 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 down.
Slow it down.
It's time to slow it down, 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 down.
Slow it down.
We steady breaking down that cush, nigga. Roll it up. Talking about money, we gon' get it up.
Oh, hell no. I don't even want to say his motherfucking name because it's disgusting to me, man. But how in the fuck are you going to impregnate your kids and have kids by your daughters? This nigga impregnated his kids and had over 6 kids with his daughters. You know what I mean? He got sentenced to 50 years. Then one of his daughters came up and gave him more information, and they gave that nigga 90 years. But it ain't how many years they gave him. It's how in the fuck can you have sex with your daughters, impregnate them, have kids by them, and what the fuck is going on with people in this world? Man, I got a 12-year-old daughter. I can't even look at her that way. You know what I mean? It's like, one time I had to tell my daughter to put some clothes on because the shorts was too damn short. It's like, your daddy don't want to see that shit. How can another man impregnate his kids? Like, you know what I mean? But for a black motherfucker to do it, it's like, wow, that shit isn't close to home, man. It's like, you know, you have Mexicans that have sex with their cousins and their in-laws. You have Asians that do it. And you got white people that eat up their family members and shit. So it kind of hit home when it was another black guy that impregnated his motherfucking own daughters. That's my all hell no. Man, they gave your ass 90 years. They should have gave your motherfucking ass that chair. Because that's some gross shit, you know what I mean? That's my all hell no, man. I don't even want to talk about it too much. I just want to put that bitch ass thing on Front Street, on Ear to the Streets, and man, keep your dick in your pants, man. If you ever think about having sex with one of your kids, man, go seek professional help. Most Hated Mob, that's my all hell no, 2014, and I hate to begin it off like this, but this is some sick shit, and they need to know. This nigga, he directed a video for the Fugees, you know what I mean? And it's just crazy how he's the Grammy nominee. He's a nigga that's been in the game. How can you? Oh hell no.
Nah. My time at Death Row was like college, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah, absolutely.
Then after everything went down, we was in the pros, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
So I learned a lot from great producers, like, you know, of course Dre was over there for a hot minute before he bounced. Dads, you know what I'm saying? Hurting Bad, Daryl Harper.
Yeah, me and my nigga did a song together, man. We got a couple of songs together, man. Y'all check it out,
definitely,
man.
Definitely did. A couple of bangers.
Yeah, a couple of bangers, man. And I got one more album for you, you know what I mean? I just ain't did nothing to him, you know what I mean? But the beat got your name all on it. I just said still.
Let's have it, man. They waiting on it.
What's next for you?
Man, just pushing this OG. You know, be on the lookout for a clothing line that's going to be out there real soon. I ain't going to put the name out there because I don't want nobody stealing it, using it before I can produce it. But I'm also writing a book. I already finished the book, a novel that's going to come out called Street Fame. Then I'm doing a story of my life, you know what I mean, of my game, my life in the rap game. You know, everything that came along with it. And, just mashing, man. Just keep doing what we do.
You got a radio station, don't you?
Yeah, I got a show, man, called The Real Talk Show, man. You can see it every Tuesday night on TRadioV.com from 6 to 7. You know what I'm saying? Me and my girl, David Payne, we talk about everything on there. But one thing we always do, we keep it 100.
Keep it real.
Talk.
Just keep it 100. That part right there, man. That shit right there. And that's why I fuck with my nigga E.D.I. Mean, man. I give this nigga so much respect and love, man. Because, hey, my nigga, it ain't too many more niggas out there like us, homie.
Yeah, that's unfortunate, too, man.
That's fucked
up. Lonely out here, man.
That's fucked up. That's fucked up, homie.
It's lonely, man. And you got to keep your circle small, man. You know what I mean? But salute to you for doing what you do.
Oh,
you know what I mean?
Man.
Congratulations on the show.
Yeah,
you know what I mean? Parlay a real one, man. You know what I mean? He always kept his word since day one, since I met him. That's why I rock with him.
Likewise,
yeah.
My nigga, likewise.
Yeah,
man, I'm glad you came and fucked with your boy, man.
Man, it was a pleasure, man.
Man, we smoking this good weed, man, and just sitting back. Get that motherfucking new
song line everywhere.
It's hot. Trust me, man. You put that motherfucker in and just ride. And one thing I like about my nigga album, man, he got shit to where you can relate. He even got shit to bounce. He got that shit you can bounce to. He got that on his album, too.
Yeah, you can bounce to this
shit. Yeah, he got some shit on, some club shit is what I meant to say. He got some club shit on.
Bouncing and thinking at the same time.
Now, that's what I'm talking about. You motherfuckers need to think more, you know what I mean? And that's what that album gonna do for you. It's gonna make you motherfuckers think. And he got that kind of album to where if a motherfucker going through something, you know what I mean? He got songs that can relate to that shit, you know what I mean? He got songs to relate to that shit. You know what I mean? These niggas be making albums. They make a whole motherfucking album in 1 or 2 weeks. Nigga, that's not no album, homie. Ain't no way no nigga. It take me 1 or 2 weeks to write a song because I'm putting thought into it. I'm putting research I'm doing because music is a message. Am I lying?
Absolutely. You're definitely not lying. You know what I mean? Music is like life. It's what you make.
Fuck with us, man. This my nigga E.D.I. Mean, man. Much love. The Outlawz and shit, man.
Much love to you, man. Appreciate you having me, my
dog. Come on, man. We team
show
real
with our Parlay Starr on this mission, man.
We
team
on
real one.
Hot.